We knew going into this that this was going to be an uphill battle. The Republican Party has had a lock on the Independents Party for a generation or more, and so we knew this would be an uphill battle. My goal here was to give voters a choice and have an opportunity to put our message before the voters that government is supposed to work for everybody, no matter who you are and who you know, and that this community needs some new leadership, new energy, and new ideas to move forward and really have progress on the issues and challenges that face us. And I'm pleased today because the results, we came about 200 votes away from winning a line that Republicans have had a lock on, like I said, for a generation. And so I'm very pleased with that, and we're going to keep going tomorrow and keep bringing that message all over Monroe County. I have every confidence in the world we're going to be successful in November.
You spent a lot of money campaigning to win this line. Does that hinder you at all moving forward through the summer?
No, it actually gave us an opportunity to talk to a lot of voters. You know, this is obviously a long campaign season. This started a lot earlier than it usually does. So we had an opportunity to have a conversation, knock on doors, yes, mailers, things like that, phone calls to talk to voters and get this message out. And like I said, to come about 200 votes away from winning a line that the Republicans have had for a generation is, to me, it's encouraging the direction this campaign is going. This is, we're getting our message out that this community really does need some new leadership and new energy. And frankly, like I've been saying, this government is supposed to work for everybody. It doesn't matter who you are and who you know, it should work for everybody. And that message is coming across loud and clear.
So okay. You don't have the independent line anymore. How could that impact the Democrats moving forward for the November election?
Well, like I said, there's over 60,000 more Democrats than Republicans in this community. I feel good about where our position is. So frankly, to come again 200 votes away in this, it's basically, you know, a toss up there. And so I feel very good about where we're heading. And the response at the doors has been incredible, to be able to talk to voters one-on-one over the last several months and you know, hear their concerns about the county. This election is going to be won, you know, based on showing voters that we can do something different in Monroe County. If we're going to do things the same way we've been doing them for 20 or 30 years, we're going to be the exact same place we are 20 or 30 years from now as we are today. We need new energy and new leadership, and we can really start to tackle some of these problems. I also think people in this community are growing tired of politicians saying one thing and doing another. You see it in Washington with the president, you see it right down here into local county government. People saying one thing, doing another thing. They tell you they're cutting your taxes, they're really raising them. They tell you we have better budgets, it's one of the worst in the state. They tell you we have better credit ratings, it's one of the worst in the state. They tell you they're doing an across-the-board increase for early intervention funding, when in fact, they're not. So it's you know, people are starting to realize there's a better way to do things, and we can actually start to impact those challenges if we roll up our sleeves, work together, bring people together, and make progress.
Safe to say you're not going down without a fight. You are going to continue to hit the ground running as far as campaigning on the campaign trail.
Oh, absolutely. The campaign continues tonight into tomorrow. I mean, this is a long campaign cycle. This is a long, but like I said, I'll go back to, we knew this was an uphill battle all along. I mean, the Republican Party has had a lock on this nomination for a generation. So to be about 200 votes away from taking that, I want to thank the voters who came out and frankly bucked their party's leadership that has been in the pocket of the Republican Party for a very long time, the chairman of that party. I want to thank those voters who stood up and said enough is enough. We want to be independent, we want to have our voices heard, and we think that this county government should work for everybody, and it shouldn't just work because of who you know.